if you get him with the right cards. So, I have not drafted on stream in quite a while, but I am perfectly happy to try out the new draft format. I haven't actually done any of the tournaments yet. But I would like to try out... Do I have a draft coupon? Nope. Enter with event tickets. I only have 57, so... All right. In draft, we start out... from everything I hear, Utera is the faction to pick. There is nothing in this first hand that I can use to force Utera. I'm not going to play AN, so Allomancer's out. Actually, this is a terrible first pack all around. I've got two patrons, which would require me to have a significant presence of that faction in my deck. So they're not great. Patron of Tarsus is still pretty good because when you trigger him, he's just dominant at level 2 and 3. War Machine is Overload, meh, not a significant presence in draft. Heartseeker and Ice Crusher are also both pretty meh, so I'm going to go with Patron of Tarsus and favor Necrium, but try and pick up some strong Utera to go with it. Alright, with Utera, I'm probably going to pick up the Herd Mother. I don't know how she's going to play in draft. I don't know how easy Raid is going to be to trigger. But if memory serves, things... I don't know. The Symbiote is also really good. Not the first level, but level 2 and 3. I want to take the Herd Mother. Force Utera. Get out of that. Let's see. Yuck. I'm not a big fan of any of this. Heals aren't ever really very useful in draft or in any game unless you're playing Wagyu, and even then, if you're playing Wago, go burn in a fire. Grimgott Spectre, not a spectacular card, not terrible. You gotta waste a level 1 play basically to get a good level 2 and 3 with mobility. Another Herd Mother, not convinced that Raid is going to be the way to go. Festering Slime is interesting removal. It's kind of like a blight zombie, except it gives minus minus, so it can still be effective against higher level creatures. I might try this. Don't know how good it's going to be. I don't think it's going to be very good, because a 1-6 is nothing. Torgmai Mender is the pick out of this. It's a creature with a utility. Deep Branch, Ancient, way too hard to trigger. Scatter the Seeds is worthless. I'll take the Restless Wanderers because it's a creature over the Scatter the Seeds. I'm going to go with Dryad's Boon here. That, if I can pick up the right cards, can synergize well with any other growing creature. I haven't seen a lot or any. Actually, have I seen any? Is there any hard removal? I'm drafting Necrium, but I'm not seeing any hard removal. I'll take the 8-8. And I'll take another Wanderers just because it amuses me. Symbiote should be the right pick here. Actually, I want to take the Symbiote. I don't need the silver. If you're drafting for the silver and you already have one Wanderers, taking a second's not a terrible thing. It's not a good thing. You're not going to be able to make a Wanderers deck in draft. There just aren't enough of them because they're heroic. But it's still more silver. But I'm going to take the Symbiote. Rot Fiend is always a solid pick. Strong body at every level. Yes, it loses some if it gets locked after the fact. But dropping it down in front of something is almost always worthwhile. And we'll take another buff. Yeah, I'm not going to go with that. Scourge Knights, if it's played in formation, gives minus minus to a creature. Not great stats, but nice utility. I don't want to take the Contagion Lord. I don't want to take the Demon Web. Deathseeker, maybe Blightwalker, but I think I'm going to go with the Scourge Knights just because I've never played with them before. Grave Pact, Organ Harvester, and Blightwalker. Okay. This one I'm a little bit torn. Probably the Deep Branch Prowler, although Group Meal can be very powerful in draft. But I need more underdrops. Man, I wish I had stats on these creatures over here, like we had in the old client. I've got one, two... Yeah, I've only got two underdrops right now. Underdrop I'm defining as anything with 6+ attack, which would be the Deep Branch Prowler and the Rot Fiend. Everything else is 5 or less. Definitely need more underdrops. Oh, so tempting. Only hits with Terra creatures, though. I think I'm going to pass and take... Gosh, this is a terrible pick. I think I'll take the Shardclaw Crusher as a proactive buff. This thing's been buffed at some point in the past. Because I swear it was a 3/3/6/6/9/9. Grove Matriarch. Very solid creature. Has been ever since Alpha. Zombie Titan's also very solid. And I think I'm actually going to take the Zombie Titan over the Grove Matriarch. But that's probably a mistake. Worthless. Take another Rot Fiend. Gets me another solid underdrop. Bear Rider jumps up to an 18/10 at level 3. Not great, but I think it's what I'm going to take. This is a new card I've not played with before. 5/9/13. Not great health. Slightly below average stats. Don't want a Contagion Lord. Don't want Ferrix. Maybe I want Ferrix. Nah, we're going to try this new creature. When in doubt, try the new creature. And that. Oh, I'm only 20 out of 30 cards. Jeez. Let's take that to facilitate raids with that Herd Mother I took earlier. Again, I have a Zombie Titan versus a Grove Matriarch. I'm going to take the Grove Matriarch this time. Another Rot Fiend. Another Rot Fiend. And Gloom Reaper. Oh, I should have taken the Savage Oath, so I have a surprise breakthrough card. Oh, well. Too late now. And we'll take... Takes buff so well, but I don't have that much... I guess I have a Dryad's Boon. I could drop a Dryad's Boon on an Ossuary thing. Hey, Twin Strength. There we go. Harbinger of Spring. There we go. Rot Fiend. And a Deathseeker. Alright. Let's see how this goes. This is now red instead of purple on my searching bar. This is the first tournament I've done in the new client. Magic Shisha. So now this is more, you're probably more likely to see newer players. Everybody wants to draft. Drafting is good. So we will open up with a Spirit Stone Dryad in the middle of the board. Hoping for Harbinger of Spring in my next hand. Game. There we go. Not get the Harbinger of Spring. Got a Symbiote. Dryad's Boon. This will brood over there. There'll be a 5/5 with one regen. And a Plunder Imp will take out the Chisel Hearth Archer. But they can take out. Ten Regen 2 doesn't sound bad. I might be better served. I would battle first. Getting my override out with the Shark Claw. Give myself an option on the next turn if I draw something cool. Yeah, we'll do that. On spawn and throw the symbiote for an even trade over here. Hopefully he doesn't have a zombie dread knight. Finish railing against zombie dread knight and constructed just to go to draft and get it to beat me up here. Did he make me discard? Oh, the Death Seeker. That makes sense. That'll kill, that won't. Drop the Rot Fiend over here. Really? Ugh. Somewhat frustrating here. It's tempting to do that, just because the Festering Slime is going to be so annoying to kill. But I think I want to do the Zombie Titan. And yeah, we'll try the new cards. Don't just rely on cards that I know how they work and how effective they are. Let's throw out a giant slime. Probably a mistake. Would much prefer to use that on something that has regeneration. Oh, hey, my gold portrait still shows up here, too. Awesome! I can feel privileged and elite now. Hermes, so that's not going to attack. Interesting. And Contagion Fiend. Okay. Let's drop the Dryad's Boon. Make this slime really scary. Battle. Drop the Rot Fiend. Throw the slime. Fortunately, the slime is in the middle lane. That was, consequence of the way this is played out, but is a major problem, actually. Hey, Arzakhan! Glad to be back. My daughter and wife are both back taking a nap. Got company coming over probably around 5:30, so I won't be on too much longer. Shrink, shrink. Let us throw the Shard Claw Crusher there. And the Felstrider there. Hey! Thanks, Hectares, for hosting the stream. Welcome to all of Hectares' viewers that aren't already overlapping with my own viewers. Mathna here, doing some drafting now from requests in the channel. Got myself up to gold 1. Nice little gold ring around my portrait. A nice touch. I appreciate that. Wonder up, and there goes my slime. Give an enemy creature -3 attack. Okay, well, that seemed worthless, but would have totally done it to that. Plunderimp took out my thing. So we will just go with that and that. Not a big fan of this, the way this is going right now, but I do have a solid board state. I've been playing Constructed so long, playing some of these cards, like, really? Is that what I really have to play? I don't know. Okay, now I've got a Herd Mother and might be able to pull off a raid. Sonic Pulse. Awesome. Double Sonic Pulse. Well, I definitely get to pull off a raid. I am equally definitely going to drop something on top of this -2/8 over here. Probably the Herd Mother. I've got 1, 2, 3 creatures attacking, so I can't overwrite this. Still get the raid off. That's going to be a big creature for me. Battle and go ahead and drop the Spirit Stone Dryad right there. But I do not expect the Rot Fiend to continue to live. Let's see here. J-Roy. I'm sorry, J-Roy. You'll get up there, though. Ow, that sap kind of stings. That sap stings a lot, actually. So I've got a raid going. I might as well go all in here. Yeah, that was a dumb play. Yes, the raid is going to get it back up, but then it's going to go right back down because it's got a 9 attack creature in front of it. That was a dumb play. I should have put that on pretty much anything else and just accepted the loss of the Herd Mother. Now, if he leaves the Herd Mother alone here, I might Dryad Spoon to it and see what we can get out of that. Now, it's probably also a mistake, but in for a penny, in for a pound. Yeah, no, that will not be happening. That would be dumb. Battle there. Yeah, I don't like using the Dryad's Bloom 2 on a Rot Fiend 1. Well, I guess it's better than a Rot Fiend 2. I've got a formation creature that could be useful. Thunder Imp takes out anything he wants from my hand and kills that. I think I'm going to lose at this point. Because I have all rank ones now. And I'm up against a full board. Really nothing I can do about it. Not quite nothing, but close enough. I need a strong hand here. Really strong hand. Nope, I lose. I can't kill the Plunder Imp. Can't even come close to killing the Plunder Imp. Let alone the Abyssal Brutes. Yep, that's game. Alright, we're off to an 0-1 start. Maybe I'm not the right person to talk to about how to draft, Uggvines. Yeah, Plunder Imp is a pretty solid card. It's got good stats and can let you proactively prevent playing of some significant threats. Now, since you don't know if your opponent has the significant threat ahead of time, and it is a narrow enough trigger condition that it's not always going to work, how do I have 4 million silver? I've been playing Solforge since launch. I was really good at it for a while, with lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of 4-0 constructed queues. Even back when we had shareable legendaries, which means that I was getting double value out of my old legendaries. I have a near complete playset. Not quite complete, but close. Alright, off to an 0-1 start. But yeah, I've been playing for a while, if you look at my numbers in here. 364 legendaries. I will admit to having spent some on the game. Actually, a pretty decent amount. I'm not a whale or anything, but across, has it really been 3 years? I've spent probably $250 to $300 counting the tournament fees. Seriously, why are we connecting? Try reloading it. Since I have the battle button, I'm fairly certain that this is me. I have no cards. Game. Not liking this. We'll close Solforge and restart it. No longer sharing legendaries. I'm not quite sure what you mean by that. I am pretty much out of legendaries to give away as part of giveaways. I have some of the new set. There we go. Zombie Titan. But not a lot to go around. And I've already used some of it, but most of my new legendaries to fill in the gaps for decks I want before I spend my silver. Thus far, I have crafted one of the new legendaries. Progeny of Zith. Awesome. Means I can throw down the symbiote and get regen on the thing. Symbiotes. We'll try this. He's got a Justicar, so it may come back and be a major problem, but we'll see. Okay, there goes the Justicar. Okay, that lends credence to the idea of playing Torgmai Mender and a Sorrow Maiden. Not much I can do about the Sorrow Maiden. I'm going to drop the Torgmai Mender here. I drop Torgmai over here, buff the symbiote since it's got regen, and Deep Branch Prowler there. Alright, I got Scourge Knights, and I'm bored full enough that I probably will be able to get the formation off. Probably. There's a general, Scourge Knights. So Sorrow Maiden, what are you killing? Okay. Yes, I do it to that. See reason not to. So we drop the Scourge Knight here, shrink his Scourge Knight. Battle. And we will go ahead and drop a Harbinger of Spring. I don't have a lot in the deck that will trigger that though. I think we'll drop the Shard Claw Crusher. He'll heal back up to 10 health. Got a new symbiote. That'll be regen 4, so that probably goes in front of the Progeny of Zith. Getting rid of its third rank at long last. Scavenger Scorpion. 4-6, yeah, that will trade off, unfortunately. It's Embrace. That will do more than trade off. That will kill it. Let's go through there. And you there. Torgmai Mender 2. Awesome. You can do the same thing I did with Torgmai Mender 1 and give the giant regenerating creature more health. Forge Guardian Beta. That, unless he has a way to buff it, is an even trade, which is great. Not the right kind of buff. Okay, so Mender goes there. Buffing him, of course. Rotfiend goes there. And Zombie Titan gets a free lane at the right to use. Awesome. Might Shardclaw Crusher the Zombie Titan, in fact. Depends on what he does, but that'll pretty much give me an undeniably dominant board state. Oh, please don't. Don't respawn in the right lane. Oh, good. They respawn the same way. And you are okay. Yeah, I think I just want to do this. He doesn't have any hard removal that I've seen. So make a giant zombie titan. Now I've got giant regenerating creatures in both the left and right hand lanes. You're minus four, minus four. I think this game is over though. As always, I could be mistaken. Group meal. Nice. Patron of Tarsus. Got three Decrium cards. Scourge Knights. Got the Scavenger Scorpion. Win. Yeah, this game's over. Might take me a little bit, but I don't see how he comes back. I just spread the board and he dies, not... Yeah, there we go. Concession. Good game. Good game, Halo Chaos. All right, so I didn't go winless on my first draft tournament of the new client. At 1-1, I need six more in a row. Saint Bob. All right, Mr. Saint Bob. All right, so what do we start out with? This is a terrible opening hand. I'm just going to start with a Death Seeker and call it a turn. Oof, man. So yeah, when I said that I was getting double value, back in the day, if you bought gold tickets, you functionally seed your account. And any tournament rewards you got with those tickets would pay out more tickets that were also gold tickets. So once you got one gold ticket, as long as you didn't hit zero, you always had gold tickets. And that meant that all the legendaries that you got from then until about, what, 8-9 months later, some significant amount of time, were all worthwhile. And then when you go online, there are people that you can easily find that will do just legendary swapping with and trade any legendary for any legendary and then scrap all of your junk legendaries and you get two legendaries value out of one. Which is how I got to that 4 million gold. Not gold, silver. 4 million silver. Five rats. We will go with the zombie titan. I want to go ahead and put out this tiller. Again, trying out the new cards, seeing how they work, how effective they are or aren't. That guitar sprite annoys me because, well, it is a poor man's Bright Steel Gargoyle. Ooh, Necromoeba. That is always a strong draft card. But now you can't overwrite your Katara sprite, because if you do, it has nowhere to spawn. There's nothing I can do about it, but one, two. So it's only got two attackers. Drop you there. Oh. Really? It's random? Oh, spawn, darn it. I was thinking for some reason I get to choose what lane that went into. Silly me. So we'll do that then to kill him. And realistically, I have to kill that, otherwise that gets to grow even bigger. I guess I could block that. Yeah, I think that's the right way. Battle. Then just throw a Rot Fiend to take care of the Raid Mother. Herd Mother. Herd Mother, not Raid Mother. Oh, I completely understand the change. I do miss the gold tickets, though. Let's see here. So there's a Blightwalkers. I think we go with the Tiller there, and the Matriarch there. See if I can make a comeback now. Darn it. Oozling spawned in the worst possible location, or best for him, depending on how you want to look at it. Herd Mother, and he's got three attacking creatures. Gosh darn it. Yeah. That is quite large. There's really not much I can do about it. Okay, so I need to clear. That. Activate. On over there. Okay, so I've got a blocker. And I guess we'll just drop that there. That clears out, so he doesn't have the three attackers. Fortunately, I don't have a 10 attack creature. Or any level 2 creature. So Brute. That'll be a 5-5. Eternal Visage. This will be even bigger. We will throw the Herd Mother. No, I can't throw the Herd Mother. They won't grow. Ah. We'll just go Rot Fiend, Rot Fiend. Don't like that, but what else can I do? I guess I could have dropped the Fellstrider, taking the 50-50 shot at getting a second block and not taking 15. Might have been wise. Hi, Lucky Dog. So Uggvines, the 20 card constructed, yeah, okay, so Dragon, I already said, it's a weekend warrior. Every weekend, starting on Thursday, running through Sunday, they put out a special queue. What that entails varies from week to week to week. I think, oh gosh, I wish you could do that. Can I? Dropping that there and that there. Dropping that takes another 30. Think that's the better option, though? Yeah, we'll do it. That goes there. Scourge Knight is -4/-4, so that'll let me take out the Necromeba. Battle. Unfortunately, the Herd Mother is going to get to grow again because he's got 3 attacking creatures. Finally, though, I have a creature big enough that I can throw in front of it and kill it. I could have killed it last turn. I chose to take 30 damage instead. Really, Dendrify? Really? Oh, come on. I don't have enough? I really thought I did. I missed the regen from Infernal Visage. Oh, I'm so dead. So dead. Now I have to overcommit to killing that. Okay, fine. I'm overcommitted over there. He'll wipe my board. And I won't be able to use my Scourge Knight 3 ability. All I have to do is drop anything in front of the Rot Fiend. Oh, a Herd Mother, of course. Yeah, this game's over. I am going to go 1-2 in my first draft. I have no idea if this is going to work, but I'm going to try it. Nope. Did not give me the formation, so I'm dead. I have nothing that can kill anything in that hand, so let us retire from this draft and go 1-2. It has been a long time since I drafted. I think that should be fairly obvious with how that went. No. Oh, look, nothing. Yeah, that was somewhat disappointing. I also hate the tickets. You don't get tickets back. There is no way to go infinite. You will eventually run out of tickets, and when you run out of tickets, you're done. Wait, no, that's not true. I'm lying to you. I went 1-2. That's why I got no tickets. I was terrible. Oh. Yes, Uggvines, if you are a brand new player, your best bet to build a collection is honestly to wait until there is a guaranteed legendary weekend draft. But those come up maybe once every 2 or 3 months. And it's really annoying just to sit there and wait. So yeah, you're right. Playing draft is definitely the way to go. Yeah, I suspect Restless Wanderers will come up quite frequently in draft. So I'm going to try one more draft. There goes 4 event tickets. Okay, this is more interesting to me. I'm going to go Alloyan here and take Automaton Prime if Information gets 4 armor. And then 4 Suterra, yeah. Take Augmentation. I can't believe Augmentation's back. Take Tower Scout for the nice mobility creature. Sky Knight Glider for the nice mobility creature. Mobility is very helpful for formation. You do. Breakthrough. Yeah. Take a Savage Oath for a surprise breakthrough. Forge may level and discard my level 147. In rank, new data from. Yeah, we'll take that. It's been a while. The beta is awesome, has always been, will always be. Well, I don't know if it will always be. But six drop is a nice underdrop. Yeah. Ordnance Captain is ridiculously strong. He's the new Matrix Warden. I can't see why you wouldn't take that. Another Grove Matriarch. The Tower Scout. Sky Knight. Deep Branch. Armory Outpost. Core Attack. Not great. There's nothing really great in this pack. We'll try this. See if it ever comes in useful. Sonic Pulse. Another Deep Branch. Steel Skin. And Garbage. Let's see here. Haven't really got anything that lets me get armor added. Guess the Steel Skin. Makes Batterbot not terribly useful, so I'm going to go with another Grove Matriarch. Another Tower Scout. That pack. Does not negate Defender anymore. So sad. Like the Alpha. Raptor. That pack. Ordnance Captain. A Hunter. Dryad. And Bear. Alright. See if we can have better luck this time. Actually, this probably needs to be my last game. I need to get ready for company. So, yeah, this will be my last game of the stream. I thank you all for watching. I probably shouldn't be playing this game, but I lost track of what time it was. Oops. Spring Dryad in 4, Sky Knight in mid. All turn. Dryad is scary powerful. I don't have a lot of support for Dryad in this deck. I didn't get very many token spawners. Or any token spawners. Well, I guess I got the Grove Matriarchs. But yeah, not much in the way of... Double its attack. They hit a 6-7. Okay. Dryad. Sky Knight. Patron of Anvilon. Oh, Totem Bound Berserker. Okay, I would totally have not played that in that lane. Because now I can move away from it and not sacrifice my Sky Knight to it. If it played it, say, over here, he could have forced it over and couldn't have escaped. We will get you out of the way. Up you there, and Sonic Pulse. That doesn't seem unreasonable. We get some trade-offs. Sonic Pulse really bought me card and a half advantage. I guess you could argue it's more than that. Because the Totem Mountain Berserker will kill whatever I throw in front of it next turn. Yeah, that worked out well. Scales terribly. It scales better than it used to. This has gotten buffed at some point, too. From Frozen, it used to be 3, 4, 5, not 4, 6, 8. I really should start looking at my cards before I play them so that when they've been buffed, I know. Or properly realize it, or whatever, however you want to say that. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and level up the beta. And drop the Spelunker. Gets the second armor on it so it survives this combat. Ooh, okay. This is going to be an interesting choice. Scipion Augmentation is so tempting. It's kind of a bad play now, but it makes for awesome possibilities later. Go ahead and activate that guy. Okay. Problem is, that I don't really want to play it on a beta 1. I'd rather drop Automaton Prime. So Destruction. They hit me for 3, but still have the option for Formation. I don't know. If I take the damage for the better board state, I'm going to do it. Overwrite. Goodbye. I'm sorry. Oh, that hurts. Now I have a free Scipion Augmentation in the deck. I have a significantly worse board state, but free Scipion Aug. Which comes right up. So I will be able to buff my Ordnance or Automaton Prime more. Really, Hermes? Oh, sir, this has had Defender negated, so he cannot get it. Overwhelming Force. Really? Fine. Be that way. Well, Scipion Aug obviously goes there. 9, 6, 9, 8. So that would kill that. I would rather that not happen. Do I have an option? Play the Ordnance Captain anywhere? I have to level the beta, so we're going to do that. And open lane the beta. So it'll take a 9 attack creature to take out my Automaton Prime. That's fine. If he doesn't, though, I get to give it more armor. I'm going to do that even if it's not worthwhile, but. It's all about the board state. Try and use your life total as a resource to get a stranglehold on the board. Omen, I've definitely been there before. Getting those top decks are painful. So you doubled your. Okay, I think we will drop Sky Knight and Steel Skin. Feel pretty good about my chances at this point. Drop Spring Dryad, move Sky Knight, drop Sky Knight. Firelight Hunter. You're going to take out my Sky Knight or Steel Skin. Okay. Second play. Bronte Bolts. Give that guy Defender. Thinks that's still going to be able to move over there and make that a positive trade. Excellent. Perfect. $111 to $74. Used up a lot of my life total, but I'm in a pretty strong position at this point. And what I've got leveled is also pretty strong. I've got Free Sipian Og, Chiselhearth, Forge Guardian Beta 3, Sky Knight Glider 3, and Steel Skin 3, eh, Spring Dryad 3. And I'm going to get to play an Ordnance Captain this turn to make my board stronger. And I get a Grove Matriarch to the deck. Yeah, this feels pretty good. I like my odds. Again, Totem Bound could have easily... Well, okay, that might actually be the right place to put that. Move you over. Drop Grove Matriarch there. Ordnance Captain there. Buffing the board. Small buff, but buff nonetheless. And there's my Beta 3. Be nice if I could put that in the middle lane, but I suspect that I want to put the Ordnance Captain in the middle lane. I don't know. Maybe I'll just go ahead and splurge and put the Beta in middle. So that gets to be really big. Really big. And a Hermes. Fascinating. Yeah, I think I'm going to throw... Gosh, I don't know. That guy is so big. I think I got to do it this way with the Beta over here. And it's 5. Yeah, we're just going to throw the Sky Knight there. I think that's best for the long-term viability of this game. I wish I'd thrown Beta in mid. Darn it. Would have been able to put the Steel Skin Spelunker's armor on something worthwhile instead of a cat. That's what's going to happen, I think. Four armor, right? Yep. All right, Tarant. Firelight Hunter, blow up. I would hit... Doesn't take out the... Yeah, okay. Get 6 damage to me. Okay. Fine with that. I'm going to drop a cat in mid. And steel skin spelunker in one. 19. Entered my creature. Okay. I can live with that. At mid. Spelunker in one. And the defender goes away off of my Beta. It's going to sit out there and continue being an imposing presence. La da 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 da. Thought I would have heard from my company by now. All right, now I feel strong. My hand is terrible, but my board state was decent. I drop a deep branch and I armory outpost them. Because none of this is worth playing here. Take my 30 damage. You go to 8, right? Now, everything I have out there is very killable. Trick is that it's going to take whatever you play against me with it. And then I'm going to drop something in mid that has mobility with 15 attack. So yeah, I think this match is now decided. Timer going down. Yes, Ugvine's mobility does stack. That. Another 12 damage on him. Armory outpost is 6 now. 6 and 6 and 6. That's tempting. Bordering on potentially game winning. There's no way the Spring Dryad is unblocked. But the cat might not survive. If the cat doesn't survive, I don't think it's. Duranti Bolt. Of course you do. Okay. So now I assume the cat's going to survive. Oh gosh, that was terrible. What are you? Oh gosh. That's called desperation, because you don't have anything that can handle what I have on the board. That's just going to make things worse. I know it probably was all you could do, but I play two rank twos, one of which is not even really a rank two. It's like 1.5. Why are you 9-9? All right, come on. course you are. They got buffed quite a while ago and then caused draft all sorts of problems. Dragwalker. I guess that does trade off, but I don't see how you're getting around the fact that I have 19 damage coming. Yeah, that's game. Good game. I'll give myself a little bit of overkill just in case I can't add. 10 plus 9 is 19. I'm sorry, but I've made dumber mistakes before. I can't think of one, but... All right, so I think we're going to call it there. I'm 1-0 in this draft. No one is going to find a match in this thing. Let's go ahead and cancel this. Get my... I believe it's going to be a silver pack. Buy old constructed queue. Is it really going to let me do this? Oh, wow. So as long as you had an old constructed queue active, you can keep queuing up in the old constructed queue. That actually might be a bug for SBE to go take a look at. I'm going to go ahead and concede this one, but good game, Melman. Because I have to be done. I need to get some stuff picked up in the next 15 minutes before company arrives. But there's an interesting bug. Let me go shoot Stoneblade a note about that. Which, Solforge game. So apparently... Anyways. Old Constructed is the best of... Well, not best of... Yeah. You play four matches, and you get the bronze, silver, gold, or platinum packs. It's what it was before it was this. Play until you lose two or win seven. So yeah, there's a phantom queue out there. You can't join it unless you're already in it. But if you're already in it, you can keep joining it. That's fun. All right. Anyways, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the stream, let me know. Give me any feedback. I will be uploading probably this entire thing to Twitch in the near future. My Twitch is MathNut. Not Twitch. YouTube. YouTube is MathNut. You should be able to find me, no problem. If you enjoyed the stream, click the follow button. See if I can figure out how to host Seifert. I've never actually hosted anybody before, but want to give it a try. Good game, Jazure. I've definitely been enjoying the new client. Let's see here. Channel. I host somebody. Channel. Anybody know off the top of their head how to host somebody where it is in Twitch? Whoa, stop. Go away. Yeah, I don't know how to host him. I was going to host Safer, but I don't see it. All right, well. Oh. / host Safer Hero. There we go. Thanks, Kale. I